Hi everybody, today's quick video will be about the last test we're really going to spend time with. There are others that we'll probably mention at times, but this is the last one that's really going to be important for us. And believe it or not, it's one you already know. We just haven't called it that yet. We haven't formally introduced it as a test. This is called the limit comparison test. We have the direct comparison test, which allows you to show that if one function bounds another function, or one series rather, is on top of another series, then we can figure out which, if one diverges, one diverges, if one converges, one converges. We can figure that out. The limit comparison test is kind of similar, except that it allows us to show that two limits, two series are effectively the same as they keep on going. So let's take a look at it. So suppose we have two series, they're both positive, okay? And for at least after some value of n. So that means that they could be negative for a while, but after a certain point, they end up being positive. Then if we take the ratio of these sequences, the ratio of a sub n over b sub n, and the ratio is a constant, that means that they either both converge or they both diverge. This is like that relative rates of growth that we did earlier. If the limit is a constant, then they grow at the same rate. And therefore, for us, that means that they either both converge or they both diverge. And that's really the limit comparison test. You'll see here that I've written two other statements as well, okay? And we can use these other two statements as well, but we're going to use the limit comparison test with number one most often. Numbers two and three are slightly weaker. This says that if the limit of the fraction goes to zero, okay, that means that the bottom is going faster than the top, right, forcing it to go to zero, okay? So what that means is that b sub n converges, a sub n converges. So what that means is that as b is getting larger faster than a, so a is moving slower than b, and b, the series for b, actually still converges. So it's getting, it's bigger than a, and it's converging, meaning that a sub n also converges. If the bottom goes faster than the top, okay, that's what happens. Number three here, we have the limit of a sub n over b sub n goes to infinity, meaning which one's going faster? Okay, it means that the top one is going faster than the bottom. So what that means is if the bottom diverges, then the top diverges. So basically, these two can be said kind of in multiple different ways. But if the limit is going to zero, that means that b sub n is going faster than a sub n. And if the limit is infinity, that means a sub n is going faster than b sub n. Okay, meaning that in the limiting sense, one is bigger than the other. So if, as in number two, the bottom is bigger than the top, okay, and the bottom converges, well then the top converges too. If the bottom is smaller than the top, okay, and the bottom converges, the diverges, then the top diverges too, okay? So we can sort of think of what this is saying is number one is saying, or number two rather, is saying that, hey, b sub n dominates a sub n, sort of. But this is not really an inequality, it's in the limit this happens. And if that's the case, then we have the same sort of result as with the direct comparison test, okay? Except here we get to use limits rather than actual functions. All right, let's take a look at how we're gonna apply this. Does this series converge? Now, we have a sense of what the answer might be to this, right? Okay, what we're gonna look at is this sort of kind of looks like in the limit, it's gonna be very similar to the series 1 over n. We can sort of compare these two, right? We can't do a direct comparison because it's going to be hard to set up an inequality appropriately to make this happen. Can we do it? Not necessarily. Okay, but in the limit we can show it's true. Okay, so I want to show that the ratio of this and this are going to have the same output. Let's do it. So we're going to take the limit of, it doesn't matter which one we put on top or the bottom, 1 over n divided by 2n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 squared as n goes to infinity. And we know how this one behaves, right? If we can show that these two are going to be pretty much the same, then we can show that these two functions, these two series behave the same way. All right, it takes a little bit of doing here, but we can do it, okay? The limit as n goes to infinity of, we're going to have 1 over n times, and we get n plus 1 squared over 2n plus 1. Okay, so we can do a little bit of simplification here. The limit as n goes to infinity. All right, And the bottom, so the numerator, I can FOIL. We'll FOIL that out because we can do this. N squared plus 2n plus 1. And the denominator, I'm going to distribute. So I get 2n squared plus n. Okay. So what are we going to get here? We know that these are two polynomials, okay? And the two polynomials are both of order 2, right? That means that they're going to go to the ratio of the coefficient of the largest terms, 1 over 2, because the polynomials are the same. This is going to go to a ratio of a half. So because this goes to a finite number that's non-zero, it means that the series 2n plus 1 over n plus 1 squared and the series 1 over n either both diverge or both converge. Since we know this is the harmonic series, and the harmonic series diverges, it means that the other series diverges as well. Okay? So that's the idea. We're showing either that two series are essentially the same, or you're bounding something in the limit, right? Which is a little bit different than what we've done in the past. Okay? Instead of saying one is always bigger than the other, we're saying that in the limit, one is a little bit bigger than the other, enough for it to go to zero or to infinity. And that's it. Okay? So we're comparing two things in the limit rather than directly. That's all we got for today, and now we're pretty much done with all our series tests. Thanks.